Hallöchen and welcome. I'm Izuna, and today I'd like to show you how I draw feline pets, combined with a quick tutorial about how to draw ears. Of course I'm talking about anthropomorphic characters here. You know me. So I start again with opening Clip Studio Paint. Let's start with something different today. First, I'd like to show you a very important thing. The difference between working from your mind and from a reference. I started to make a list. At first, I sketched a feline head, a tiger, just from my imagination, so no ref. Then I start to, I will work with a ref, and after this, I will work just with the chibi style. The thing about your imagination, and for the tiger sketch, as you will see, is that it's full of shortcuts and mistakes. Mistakes that will that your head makes to make it easier to imagine and think about things. Clearly, I know how a tiger looks, so do you, but it differs pretty much from how it looks in real life. So you will see what I mean in a moment. I started with the circle again and drew the cross into the middle to know where he will face, in which direction the tiger will face afterwards. And then I start with the muzzle. I know where it's attached to the face, so it should be fine, I guess. Then I place the nose, eyes, ears, and I'm roughly done. It looks fine so far, for me at least, and I think it's totally okay as a rough sketch. I could refine it, but I will stick to it for now, so you just can see what I mean with working with with a reference and without a reference. Other than using my imagination, I will now take a reference and sketch from the reference directly, no tracing, of course, and you see what it will look like in the end. I picked one with a similar angle for the tiger's face. Other than using my imagination to figure out which part of the face goes where, I used the reference. I don't even need to trace to see that my depiction of a tiger's face was totally off. If I would have aimed for a realistic animal face, that means. But I learned that my muzzle was too high and I needed at least a wider angle for the forehead to look more like an actual animal face and less like a cartoonish character. Time for a little side note. I love animals, as you know, and I love flora and fauna in general, but I do not aim for a perfect depiction of animals, humans, or plants in my pictures. I aim for fantasy and also maybe a good compromise between fantasy and realism. And side note end. So you see, this tiger, or sketch of a tiger, looks way more like a tiger than my imaginative version before. Even though I did not place the ears right in the first try. And the next one is the chibi. I do love my cutesy chibis. They are so easy to draw and also so quick to draw, but you will soon see that drawing chibis has their own little traps to avoid. Circle, eyes, everything fine so far, but now for the nose and muzzle. That seems to be a problem, a big problem. Why? Because chibi is the opposite of realism. Chibi means small in Japanese. At least, that's what I know. Please correct me if I'm wrong. Another term for chibi is SD, or super deformed. And that's right, the face has to be super deformed to be cute. The version I tried with sticking to the proportions was really off. Only when I started to ignore the proportions, the realistic proportions, so making the eyes bigger, the muzzle way smaller, the ears bigger again, and then it started to come together as a chibi. So, what did I learn from this today? Stick to your guts when you want to draw chibis. Stick to your reference when you want to draw realistic. And stick to your logic when you want to draw combined realism with your imagination. Today I took with me that I will flatten the forehead and make my anthropomorphic characters look more like animals. And also I will make smaller eyes for my anthropomorphic characters. Let's see how I manage to take this into my next sketch. I opened a new file, new illustration, that means, in Clip Studio Paint, and start to draw again. I made a new layer, of course, and I start with the head. I created a circle, I added the cross in the middle, and to know in which direction the character will look in the end, and then I started to roughly sketch his body. Yes, I did not work with shapes and for this body, different than from my tutorial with chibis, because I'm so used to anthropomorphic and also humanoid bodies that I can make it up from my mind, at least if it's just a pose like this one for the upper body. But if you want me to show you how I create it, and not with just a few strokes, but really build up from shapes, then I can make a tutorial for you. Just let me know. So, as we learned, or as I learned from my previous sketches, I should not draw the nose so straight from the face. So I lowered the angle a little bit, and then started to sketch out the eyes. I know where the eyes are, because I'm so used to this proportions and this angle of drawing characters, so please bear with me this time. When I'm done with the first sketch, with the first rough sketch, you might have noticed already, but I did not. I only saw it when I was finished and had a closer or wider look at it. I noticed something was really off, and I did not know what it was, but something really just didn't work for me with this face. So I use a trick, and the trick is, for me, as it might be for you, that whenever you feel that something doesn't work in your sketch, or something seems off and you can't point it out, then you just need to change your point of view. What I mean by this is, you can use your program to mirror your image, or flip your image, or if you work traditionally, turn it upside down or hold it against a window or other light source so you can see it mirrored from the backside of your paper. This helps your brain to adjust and avoid mistakes. And see, I was right. The eye was off, and the nose too, and the muzzle was too broad, and it was good that I flipped it. Don't wonder what's going on with his fangs. It's a saber-tooth character, which I was allowed to use in this video. But he's still not muscular enough, so I need to build up more muscles. No, there was something I missed, right? I don't remember. Oh, right. Yeah, a tutorial for the ears. Huh. Okay, I nearly forgot. Sorry. So it seems I need to draw another small character to show you how to draw ears. So let's talk ears. Ears are triangles. Sometimes they are also round. Humans have another special form of ears, and I might explain another time how I draw them together, maybe with my depiction of elf ears. But today, let's stick to animal ears. I will show you, with two triangles and one semicircle, how different ears can look. All you need are two triangles and a line. At first, draw a triangle, then draw another triangle within the first one, and draw a line on the bottom of the second triangle. And now add some fluff. And that's it! Really? You can do this with circles, ovals, or you could try it with squares. I'd be very interested in your square ears, or another form of ears, maybe, I don't know, just figure something out. But it's really just those three baselines. Let me just add one thing. If you draw ears from behind, there's only one outer line. The inner line only applies if you can see the inner ear. Now let's apply this to our little angel. See how easy that went down? Cool, isn't it? But keep in mind, practice makes perfect. That's why I look forward to see your sketches, especially now that I have to do the line art and coloring. So if you want to show me your sketches, just add me on Instagram or Twitter. So thank you for joining in again. And now I'll speed up the video for you, so you can enjoy the time-lapse of the character. But first, I must apologize for not giving you the whole time-lapse, because I missed out to record the last steps, so the whole shading process is not involved this time. But I will make up for it in another video, where I show you how I shade my characters. So thanks for joining in again, and it was nice to have you here with me. Bis zum nächsten Mal. Ciao! And there's a crow in my garden. Well,